This is the Blue Lab PH pen. Again, it's very durable, well built. It's accurate to 0.1. This glass bulb here is what measures the pH. It also measures temperature as well. It's also 100% waterproof, which means you can add it into your tank, let it float there as you're adding in the acid. This just gives you time, you know, kind of got your hand, the acid in one hand, your pipette in the other. You're not fiddling around doing all this. You set it float there, add in your acid, give it a quick stir with the pen, and it gives you an instantaneous reading. It's backlit as well, so it's very easy to use. It also has a hold function as well. If you're taking the pH in an area that's a bit awkward, you just press the top button, it'll just hold the reading there for you. The other thing about our pH meters is we improved the calibration sequence about 2-3 years ago. So it's now incredibly easy to use. So when you calibrate to 7 and 4, you'll see a series of zeros come across the screen, and that's the meter checking for stability of the reading. It takes away the issue of calibrating too early and giving you error messages. So it's very easy. It's just very simple to use. Okay, it's very important to measure the pH of your solution. The ideal pH range is between 5.5 and 6.3. Within that range, the plants, the root system, can take up all the nutrients that it needs. pH is measured on a scale of 0 to 14, with 7 being in the middle, and you want it between that 5.5 and 6.3 kind of range. If you're too acidic or you're too alkaline, the plants simply can't take up nutrients. It's like trying to drink ice cream through a coffee straw. You kind of... And that's how the root system feels when the pH is wrong. When you get the pH between 5.5 and 6.3, what you're effectively doing is opening up the doors to nutrients. Many growers focus on the environment of their grow room. They put a lot of thought into the lighting, into the ventilation, into the pot system, into the medium. Most growers do measure EC, but a lot of growers don't measure pH. One of the questions we get asked is, how do I measure the pH of RO water? The answer is you can't. There needs to be a level of conductivity, a level of ions, a level of nutrients or salts within the nutrient solution to measure correctly pH. RO water by its very nature shouldn't have anything else in it apart from water, so the pH should be 7. If you're concerned about whether your filters are working correctly, the best method of that is to measure the EC of your water, of your RO water. If the RO water EC is 0, then you know your filters are working correctly. If you're using RO water, we recommend that you add in your nutrient first and then you adjust for pH. If you do want to know what the pH of your RO water is, the best way of doing that is to add a little bit of CalMag and get the EC up to about 0.2. The most important thing with your pH pen is to clean it, calibrate it, and make sure it's correctly hydrated in KCl. KCl is potassium chloride. This is Blue Lab KCl, but there's plenty of other brands out there. It doesn't really matter. It's all the same stuff. So KCl is potassium chloride. It's a simple salt. And it's very important because inside here is a KCl solution. It's what it needs to work correctly. The two most important things about maintaining a pH probe or a pH pen is cleaning and hydration. Inside the cap is a little sponge. It's very important that you regularly hydrate it with KCl. Just put a few drops in that sponge every time you use it. Put the cap back on and it's good to go. The other thing you need to do is clean it regularly. So we recommend that you clean it before every calibration, and we recommend that you calibrate it once a month. So we have a cleaning solution. This is a pH probe cleaner. It's just a mild detergent, has no perfume in. Perfumes tend to be oil-based, and oil is a problem on these probes. So put a little bit of this, a few drops of this in the water. Or you can put it directly onto the brush and then put it into water. And what you're doing is you're just doing this. Don't clean it like this, because you're gonna break the glass bowl. You just wanna make sure the outside of that glass is clean. And that's it. Again, rinse it under running water. We recommend you do that once a month. The most important thing with your pH pen is to clean it, calibrate it, and make sure it's properly hydrated.